As the debate continues about the nation's new health reform law, in the courts and on the campaign trail, the Kansas Health Institute has asked some experts to share their views. These interviews with providers, public officials, and people on the business side of healthcare are intended to help Kansans better understand how the law will affect them and help them sort fact from fiction and policy from politics.
Roughly 47 million of our population are uninsured. Those that have coverage in one way or another have a pretty good system, whether it be Medicare, Medicaid, or the private insurance side. If you do not have coverage, it's a failure. The system we have in this country is a failure because they do not have equal access to care as everyone else does. So they access our system through the emergency room, the wrong place, the wrong time, the most inefficient and most costly way of providing the care. If we look at the other industrialized nations of the world, many of them have had coverage for all of their population for decades. And we have made a number of attempts at that over the last 100 years, but we aren't there yet. The Affordable Care Act is really a continuation of a public health policy that was formulated really back in the 1940s, about 65 years ago. We had literally tens of thousands of soldiers coming back from World War II, and yet we had no hospitals and healthcare facilities in this country to handle all of that. Congress enacted the Hill-Burton Act, and it was the beginning of the concept of access to care for all Americans. Then in 1965, the Medicare-Medicaid program came into existence. And then in 2003, the Prescription Drug Act was passed. And then, of course, in 2010, the passage of the Affordable Care Act, which was, again, an extension and continuation of providing access and coverage to a greater segment of the population. But both sides have been working toward a comprehensive access to care over a long time. And so I see government in this case as a partner. One of the things that the hospital field did as negotiations with the administration, we agreed to forego $155 billion in compensation in the Medicare program in trade for the fact that there would be another 32 million of the uninsured covered either through the Medicaid program or through the insurance exchanges. So again, moving toward better access, improved access, and moving to a concept of coverage for all. It is not perfect, as is the case with any massive piece of legislation like this. And what I would hope is that that Congress would look at the law, tweak, fix those things that need to be adjusted and fixed, and try to move away from the political ideology war that seems to be going on today. Government is going to be involved in healthcare. Even if it's privatized, the funding source is still going to be government. So government is going to be a player. They are going to be a partner in one way or another. It's a matter of how we manage that in a sensible way.